Let us talk about truth table. So you observed in the previous videos that we have drawn truth table for all the operators out there, right? That means till now whatever operators, disjunction, conjunction we have been visiting. So in truth table, one thing is sure, we have a proposition and then values of true and false, right? So here I want to talk about the size of the truth table. Okay, if you remember your negation operator, in that case negation operator is used with your single variable, that is single propositional variable. Now you know very well that this propositional variable p can have either true value or false value. Let me talk about this true and false value. Sometimes true is represented by this number 1, the digit 1, and false is represented by this digit 0. So we might use these terms interchangeably. Sometimes instead of this false I'll be writing 0, and vice versa, and same case for this your true and 1. That means when you have one variable, it has two different possibilities. That means in the truth table you have observed that if we have this p and we are writing the possible values of not p, there are only two possible values, right? That is, when p is true, your not p is false, and when your p is false, your not p is true. So that means if you have one variable, we have two possible outputs, that is 2 to the power 1. Number of variable, so this is your number of variable, 1, so 2 power 1, that means there are total 2 possibilities in my truth table. So see, possibility 1, possibility 2. Consider two variables, number of variables as 2. If you have two variables, in that case you observed the conjunction and disjunction operator, there were 4 possibilities. That means 2 square, that means in my truth table, I am going to have 4 possible values for my proposition variable, that is p and q. Let's say q is the second variable. In the similar way, let's say if you have 3 variables involved in any kind of operation, so in that case I'm going to have total 2 cube, that is 8 possible values of true and false for the variables. Let's say if you have the variables p, q, r. In the same line, if we go on like this for 4 as well, so let us say if you have 4 variables, the size of your truth table will be filled with your total, how many, 16 different values of true and false for the 4 variables if you have this p, q, r, s. So you can see, as you proceed to larger number of variables involving proportional variables, right, if you have n number of variables, then please remember we are going to have total of 2 to the power n possibilities for true or false, right? So please keep this in mind. The size of the truth table is going to be 2 to the power n if there are n number of variables involved, right? So if there are n number of variables, right, this is your number of variables. If the number of variables involved in the study of your proposition is n, in that case your truth table is going to have how many, 2 to the power n possible combinations of true and false. So please keep that in mind, right? So this was about the size of truth table. That means if you observe for 2, 4, 8 and up to certain extent for 16, till these many values we can tolerate drawing truth table. Now if I say that there are 100 variables and if I ask you to draw a truth table having this much possible values, definitely dear, you are going to take out your shoes and throw on me, yes or no, if I force you to do that. So for that, truth table is definitely not feasible. Okay, so this was the agenda to tell you about that, what is your truth table and what are the other representation for this true and false that we use for proposition, and depending on number of variables, that is your proportional variables, how many possible combination of this true and false we can have. So please remember, if your number of variables is n, then we are going to have 2 to the power n possibilities for this true and false. Okay, and hence up to certain extent we can draw truth table, but if the number of variable becomes larger than 4, it is really difficult to draw, yes or no? 2 power 5 itself, if you see, there are total 32 possible combinations. That is quite large number, right? So please keep this in mind. Number of variables n, total possibility of true and false, 2 power n. I hope this is clear.